Namaskar. India, a country that's known for its amalgamation of different culture and diversity, is today witnessing a pandemic which most of the countries in the world are also facing. Amidst this, there is a new tension that has risen in the country. That is the border issue. India and China share their border in the northeastern part of India. In a recent physical aggression between the two countries, the Indian Army confirmed that 20 of our soldiers have been martyred. What kept the previous governments awaiting seeking development in the border for the past 70 years? There was no infrastructure established for our countrymen. There was no connectivity of roadways, railways or airways. During the UPA rule in 1962, India lost the Aksai India to China. In 1963, we again lost the Karakoram Pass to China. In 2008, we lost the Pang Nak to China. In 2008, we again lost the Chabji Valley to China. In 2009, we lost the Doom Valley to China. In 2012, we lost the Demzok to China. In 2013, we lost the Raki Nula to China. And during the NDA rule, the Chinese failed in 2017 to capture the Doklam Valley. In 2020, they again failed the Pang Song So. In 2020, they again failed the Galwan Valley. In a book, How the India Sees the World, written by the former Foreign Secretary Shyam Saran, he has revealed how India and Pakistan had agreed to an agreement to not only demilitarize the Siachen Glacier, but had also agreed on the mutual withdrawal of troops from the area. The UPA government had also proposed a joint monitoring mechanism of the Siachen area to check the incursions once troops are withdrawn from the heights. Is it that the national security was not a concern for the UPA government? In 2013, the then Defence Minister, Mr. A.K. Antony, had agreed that the Chinese had intruded our border. He had also agreed in the lower house, that's a Lok Sabha, that the Chinese soldiers are much more equipped than our soldiers. He had also agreed that the Chinese borders are much more developed than our border. In spite of the fact that the UPA government had acknowledged this very fact, that the border in China is much more developed than ours, what stopped the UPA government from procuring better equipment for our soldiers? What stopped them from developing better roads for our country? Is it that the national security was not a concern for the UPA government? What made them ignore national security to such an extent? Give it a thought. Dhanyawad.